Yeah, awesome. And that's great. And, you know, I hope you've enjoyed everything you've heard. This was a fantastic stream. The surprises just keep coming. And we'll see you next year, guys. Thank you, everybody.
It's going to be a great year.
Going to be a great year, right?
I hate you guys.
Okay. So I think we're live now. I think
we can actually. Is it working now?
Yeah.
We can officially say hello. Hello, everybody.
Hey, guys.
Welcome to our last Maxis Monthly of 2019. We're super excited to share a little holiday joy with you guys today.
You got your joy with you?
I got my joy. You're my joy, dude.
Aw. Sucking up will get you nowhere.
Yeah, it's true. Okay, so we definitely have a couple of things to cover today. We have three things to cover. Cover?
Try again.
I shouldn't be drinking this early in the morning. Three things to cover today. So the first thing that we are going to show off is an episode of Sims TV by Fire Monkeys. And they're going to give us a Sims TV update. So we are going to show a video right
now.
You
ready to do that?
We're ready. I think I can do that, right?
Do you want to count it in?
I just have to press space.
But you got to count before you press space.
One, two, three, two, one. Here we go.
I'm glad we rehearsed.
Oh, wait. I got to press play. All right. Here we go. Here we go. It's going now. Boom.
Hey everyone, SimGuru Megs here from the Fire Monkey Studios here in Australia. I'm super pumped to be back for another Maxis Monthly to talk all things Sims for mobile. As you can see, I'm in the holiday spirit, so let's jump right in for a quick update on The Sims Mobile and The Sims Freeplay to see what they're up to for the December updates right now. Introducing Briny Heights, the new neighbourhood in The Sims Mobile. Immerse your Sims in their newfound space by unlocking up to three new, unique house lots. Along with the rest of the town, Briny Heights can be visited directly from the navigation menu. Each lot has a unique landscape environment, so you can plan your next building adventure and tell special stories with your Sims. We can't wait for you to take a tour and pick the perfect location to build your Sims' next dream home. For more information on this exciting new neighbourhood, check out our special walkthrough episode of Sims TV. Patty Cakes, the celebrity pastry chef, is back in Simtown to turn up the heat and challenge you to a sweet treat holiday bake-off to prove who is the master baker. You'll be put to the test by creating culinary delights in his snow-covered, whimsical bakery venue on Parkside, starting right now. The Sweet Treat Showdown allows players to earn seasonal rewards that will help decorate your Sims' home for the perfect Christmas. And now a quick update on The Sims Freeplay. Experience a brand new journey in the Hearth of Stone quest, complete with family drama, unruly elves, and the one and only Santa Claus. Your Sim has a nagging worry about a Christmas crisis, so they're checking everything twice to ensure it's all in order. Things seem to be going according to plan, until they discover Santa Claus is avoiding his Christmas duties. It's up to your Sim to investigate and avoid a Christmas catastrophe. Complete seasonal tasks in the time limit to save Christmas and earn the Lake House Grand Prize, a multi-story, fully furnished, snow-covered lake house. You'll love the all-new external chimneys and bay windows, and even a frozen lake to skate on. How will your Sim celebrate the silly season? Jump onto your mobile app store and check out the festive fun now. Thanks for watching, and a happy holidays from everyone here at Fire Monkey Studios.
Yay! Thank you, Megs, and the whole Fire Monkeys team.
Absolutely.
That's going to be some exciting holiday content. You should definitely check it out.
I know I'm super excited about Sims Mobile getting those extra lots to build on. We really wanted more space.
Yeah. So that should be a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
Topic number two of the day. Let's talk about the community voted stuff pack.
You want to do the other thing first?
No, nobody cares about the other thing yet.
Good point. Fair.
So, community voted stuff pack. We just finished our first round of voting, and I want to give a huge thank you to the community. We had a ridiculous number of voters.
Oh, yeah.
Super surprising. Blew the first community voted stuff pack out of the water.
Almost five times as many voters, I think.
Almost five times as many voters? I can't talk today, guys. I'm ready for the holiday break. Let's get this done. No, it was a huge turnout, and it was really exciting to see the community kind of going back and forth against the themes. It was a close vote. And
extremely
I know
close.
It was extremely close. And yes. I know, you know, there was a lot of like, oh, I wish this one won, or I'm happy this one won. The winning theme ended up being arts and crafts.
Of course it did.
Knitting. So I'm excited. I think we can do a lot. So what's next? Next is going to be round two of voting. That's going to be December 23rd. So just a couple of days before Christmas, we will have the next survey out. You can go to the main menu of The Sims 4 and get led to the survey.
That's right. The link will be right up top there.
Absolutely. Or we'll put out some additional links if you need to get to it from outside the main menu.
Share it on social, like usual.
Absolutely. So the next round of voting is going to be all about the style of the stuff pack. What is the art style? So we're going to be presenting some images that'll show the room layouts as well as the cast, the Create-A-Sim layouts as well.
Some pretty early concept though, right?
Absolutely. Now, we're still working on that concept right now, but we do have a little sneak peek to show you guys just to kind of give you a taste of what's coming. Now, I want to give you a caveat. This is going to be predominantly build by art style. We're not going to be showing off the Create-A-Sim art style yet, but we're excited, and rather than wait for 12/23, we kind of want to show you now and get you thinking about it.
Well, and that cast style is going to very much work with the build.
Absolutely.
So, you know, when you're looking at this, it's still giving you an idea. You can probably picture
yes.
some of the clothing that we might build to go with these.
Yep. So, okay. So what are these art styles that we're going to be voting on? We have three art styles to vote on.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to go into an image right now to kind of show off a little sneak peek of
right
these
now?
Art styles.
Or,
right now.
Oh, right now.
Right now.
Steve, are we in the image?
You are now.
Oh, no.
Hey, okay. Excellent. So here we have our three art styles. So in the top left, we have Granny Chic. In the middle, we have Do It Yourself Delight.
The DIY delight. Yeah. That's actually the name of a sandwich I like to order.
And in the top right, we have Cozy Craft Workshop. So we're going to go ahead and zoom in on these and just kind of give you a little bit more detail.
So talk to me about your favorite piece here in the Granny Chic room.
So Granny Chic, you know, I love the doilies. I love the kind of old style furniture.
Doilies everywhere. That's definitely, takes me back to grandma's house. Right?
You know, I feel like I could walk into, you know, maybe my grandparents' house and see a lot of these elements.
The big lounger chair, especially with the skirt around the bottom, is so iconic grandma's house for me.
Yes. One thing that, you know, I'm missing in The Sims 4 right now, every time I try to kind of spin up an elder, I end up getting, like, the most interesting man in the world. And I, sometimes, you know, I want a little bit more of that granny
you want less interest?
Chic style. Not it. It's just, I don't expect my grandparents to be on the cutting edge of every trend in style. So sometimes I like to see them, you know, a little bit more...
Something more dated?
Just a little bit more dated.
Yeah,
absolutely. So there's one theme. I know there's a portion
a cool
of
one.
The community that's gonna love this. So we'll see kind of how that theme does. If we were to kind of move to the middle and we're looking at do-it-yourself delight, DIY delight. I have to get the names right.
Yeah,
there.
You don't want to confuse people.
Right. So this is more of your, you know, dare I say, like, industrial kind of workspace.
Mm-hmm.
Still has those kind of soft elements, but this is, I'm gonna appear super ageist here. This is where, like, my 20-year-old friends and 25-year-old friends, this is the type of, like, studio that they'd be kind of doing their knitting.
This has that feeling of almost, like, workshop meets crafting space. Like,
absolutely.
Someone's doing a little more intricate, like, oh, I need to do some cuts here for this
yeah.
thing, and then craft
yep.
with it.
I really like that it's gender neutral. You know,
yeah,
I can get
sure.
a guy in here doing knitting as much as I can get, you know, a female.
I feel like you can get a guy in anywhere doing knitting.
Absolutely.
There's no worries.
Again, some of my best friends are knitters, and it's that typical, you know, 25-year-old making cool stuff, and I like that it's kind of against type.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, maybe this theme will resonate with some people, and we'll see people voting towards this one.
I really want the rooster.
The little rooster?
Yeah, just be sure to tell Mike, okay?
Okay. The Mike's our art director on this one. We'll have to give him some rooster love. All right, and last but not least, Cozy Craft Workshop. Very vibrant colors.
Can we call that the CC Workshop?
The CC Workshop?
Might be misleading.
Though. Might be a little misleading. We'll get CC versions of all these, I'm sure.
I'm sure that's true. We're just giving inspiration to the community now.
And this one to me, this one kind of is, this is my parents' workshop. You know, maybe it's not quite that elder-leaning kind of vibe, that super kind of granny chic. Mm. Doesn't quite feel as modern as the last one we're looking at, so I like this kind of right in the middle.
This is actually exactly what I picture when I think of, like, SimGuru Lindsay's craft worm.
Yes.
This is it.
This would 100% be her style.
Yeah.
So this is just, you know, again, this is just a quick little look into the in-progress art we have going on. In fact, you might see that WIP in the background of these images, work in progress. So we're going to continue to flesh this out. We're going to add some Sims to it, and on 1223, these are the three styles that you're going to be voting between. And basically what that means is the art style that you see presented in these room mock-ups are indicative of the art style the pack will be. This does not mean that every single object you see in there is going to be included in this pack. That's going to come in a later vote where we're going to choose the specific build buy assets and specific cast assets that we want to select. But this right now should give you a very good indication of where the pack's kind of leaning art style-wise.
We are planning to share some of the cast looks as part of the vote as well, though.
So absolutely.
Everyone is going to be able to see kind of the styled items that come with this build-by decor.
Yep. We'll have a few Sims there and a couple of different outfits, so you should, just like looking at the rooms, you should have a pretty good idea of what that style should have to offer. And obviously, sure. If you have any questions, just hit us up on social media, and we'll probably ignore you, but maybe once in a while we'll give you a lackluster answer.
I mean, we'll almost always read what you're saying.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm going to hold on.
Steve's giving us four fingers, now one.
One All right, so we're now off mute.
It's working again.
And
Steve's finger is down.
Yeah, this just in. My naming is totally off, and I've been flipping.
You mean even after we studied?
The do-it-yourself workshop and the cozy craft flipped. So
okay, perfect.
This
but we got
one,
Granny Chic right.
Granny Chic was correct. This is do-it-yourself delight. This is cozy craft workshop. Did I get that right?
I definitely think
whatever,
next time,
dude. What
we throw the name on the art image.
You know what? The name is really unimportant. What matters is like how pretty this looks, and point to the one that you think is prettiest. When the survey comes out, it'll clearly list the
name.
We're
gonna get them right in the survey.
So just as always, don't listen to what I say. Just. I'm sorry. I apologize profusely. I don't deserve to be here. And with that, I think we're going to move along.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it time to close the book on this one?
I think it's time to close the book on this one. So, upcoming round two vote, art style for
next
the,
week. Next
for the
week.
Community
next
voted week. Stuff pack. Next Monday, says Steve. I'll believe him. Cool. So this is going off swimmingly without a hitch. I love it. Usually it's tech errors by Steve, and this time I can't blame him for anything.
Well, I mean, he was late. Well,
he was late. That's,
you know, if
that's
he had been on time, I bet we could have rehearsed.
Oh, man. How do I kick you?
Okay, so that brings us to our final topic of the day. Mm, mm-hmm. And before we get to that, so we did... Yeah, little tease. So we had a Guru Garage last week where people submitted holiday homes and we rated them on stream.
There were some awesome homes.
There was definitely some awesome homes, but I really wish there was some way that our console players could have participated in this.
Oh, that would have been really special. Yeah, I think they probably want that too.
Yeah, so, you know, maybe, I don't know, maybe we should bring console Bring gallery to console? We'll bring console to the gallery.
That's a great idea.
What do you think?
Never thought of that.
Can we do it?
I don't know if we can bring console to the gallery.
Can we bring gallery to
the
console?
We could go the other way.
Okay.
Yeah. In fact, we plan to do that early next year. So,
awesome.
The big news, which a few of you had guessed, is yes, as a matter of fact, the console is getting gallery. But the thing that I haven't seen anyone guess yet.
What's the big
news?
The
thing that I'm pretty excited about.
Yep.
You know, we talk a lot about trying to bring the community together. And when we first set out to do the console port, one of the big goals that, you know, Lindsay and I talked a lot about was we want to keep the community together. We want it to be
Absolutely.
The same game in both places. And obviously, yeah. the lack of gallery has hurt that comparison. It's like, yeah. it's almost the same, but we don't have that feature. So I'm excited to bring that out next year. The team has been working really hard.
Super
trying
hard.
To get it ready.
Yeah.
And it's looking awesome. And the best part is we're going to bring all of our communities together in gallery and actually make it cross-platform.
Yes! So this is going to be great.
What's so cool about this is we are growing the number of people who are able to get at gallery creation. So,
yes.
you know, there is a huge console audience who can now access and download the really
yeah.
exciting creations that our players have been making on the PC game.
And I love
game.
It because we are all one community here. And it's been really rough to have, you know, these arbitrary walls in between aspects of our community. So console players, yeah, it's very frustrating. Console players haven't been able to participate to the level of our PC players, PC and Mac, and, you know, vice versa. There's a lot of fantastic stylists and builders that I see on console.
Oh yeah, making some really cool stuff.
Making really cool stuff that hasn't had the opportunity to be able to share that out to the
After
community
PC
at large.
Yeah.
So me being a predominantly PC player, I'm super excited for console gallery integration just so I can start seeing some of the really cool stuff coming out of those players.
Absolutely.
Because as you all know, I'm creatively bankrupt and I just want to steal from the gallery to help fuel my own game. And this is going to give me more fuel to do that.
And I got to say, I'm kind of excited that SimGuru Legacy is going to have a little more time to help us on some other stuff now. Like, no one's going to have to tag him and say, hey, can you bring this to the console?
We've all been joking that SimGuru Legacy's social media presence, he's going to get far less
mention.
And tweets because we're not going to hear the, where's gallery? Where's gallery for console? Is gallery for console coming yet?
It's true. But
it
I
is.
Think he's excited for this as well. He's been working very hard to make it real.
Super hard. So this is going to be just a fantastic element for the community at large. I think we're all really, really excited.
Absolutely.
As Duke said, the team's been really working hard to get this supported and functioning without a hitch.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we have done that.
We have, and it's looking really good. Again, sometime early next year, we think we can go live with it. And I'm sure there are people wondering, so I just want to clear one thing up. We are not going to be able to support custom content in the console galleries. You know, I think that would be really nice. It's something we're still trying to figure out and look at, but
yep.
it is very complicated with our first party partners. And we didn't want to sit on this until we get all that sorted out, right?
Totally.
And so getting this there, it's the next step of the journey. And really, it's a pretty exciting step.
Yeah, so there's room to grow, but this is an awesome and huge first step.
This is a big deal, especially I know for myself, like build is always a little bit of a struggle anyway, but you know, it can be tricky, especially if you've been playing the PC game for a while.
Yeah.
Switching over to the console it's tough to get used to those
it's
controls
different.
When you
it's
know the PC
different.
One. And to have the ability to take this awesome build on the PC and then play the console game, right? So be playing on my couch, that's a really nice
yeah.
balance. And so I'm excited for that. Just the fact that I can even share across to myself.
Yeah, I'm so proud of The Sims 4 on console. It feels like for the first time in our history, we actually have a console version of The Sims that is as robust and wonderful as the PC. And this is just another step to eroding those barriers between those communities and actually just being able to call us one simming community.
And we'll keep working at that goal.
So I believe that takes us to the end.
You don't have anything else to say, right?
I have nothing else to say.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. What do you want to talk about? What are you going to do over the holiday break?
Holiday break. Oh, I get to visit Snow this year.
You get to, where are you going?
Yeah, off to Montreal.
That'll be nice.
So, a couple weeks in
nice
Montreal.
Nice white Christmas.
Yeah, you know, practice a little French, which I'm terrible at, so should go well.
Sweet.
But yeah, definitely white Christmas. Snow is in the forecast. It's
cool.
apparently going to be minus 15 degrees Celsius as the high the day we land, so that should be lovely.
I'm going to just huddle around the fire with some eggnog, watch some streams so I know what all y'all are saying about us, making my list of who's naughty and nice.
Does that imply you're bringing presents to the nice ones?
I will definitely be bringing home some builds of the upcoming content, so I'll probably be playing Pack Beep and Pack Beep and enjoying that.
I'm pretty excited about Pack Beep.
It's gonna be awesome. In fact, like honestly, like all joking aside, I'm really excited for next year. 2020 is gonna be a huge year for The Sims.
Biggest year yet, I think.
Biggest year yet.
We just get to say that, right?
I hope so.
Yeah.
I mean, it better.
It's our goal.
I mean, it's really up to you if it's gonna be the biggest year or not. We definitely have some surprises up our sleeve, and I think it's going to be a very interesting upcoming year, full of unexpected turns and twists, and it's going to be a lot of fun. So thanks for hanging out with us and staying an active part of this community.
We're finally at that place where I'm not convinced they can guess our next couple packs anymore.
No, no, no. It seems like we've kind of run the gauntlet of historic kind of Sims themes. You know, I you've heard me refer to them before. I always call them like lighthouse themes. They're the ones that, you know, this is a theme that you see from just miles and miles away.
Everyone's expecting it. When is it coming?
You know, when is Seasons? When is, you know, Cats and Dogs? Yep. There's certain
When's my university?
When's my university? Where's my magic? You know, and it feels like, okay, we've delivered a lot of those. So what's next now?
Now it's time to surprise.
Now it's time to surprise. So you guys will let us know if the surprises are good or actually surprising. And we're going to keep at it and try to over-deliver to you guys and keep everybody happy.
Yeah, that's right. We still got a lot more to do before we even start our break. But
absolutely.
It's going to be a big 2020.
It's going to be a huge 2020. So thanks for hanging out with us, guys. Have a magical 2019 holiday. Thank you for joining us. And we're going to see you next year very soon.
Absolutely. Happy New Year.
See you then. Happy New Year. Bye, guys.